Welcome to video lecture on data structures. Myself, Dr. Shubha S., Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science from Government First Grade College, Malleswaram, Bangalore, would like to present this video lecture. So in this video lecture, you will be learning about what is a list, the various operations that can be performed on list, what is an array, types of arrays, one-dimensional array, size of array, the different operations on arrays, array as ADT, that is abstract data type, its operations and benefits of using ADT. Now, to understand what is a list, let us see some of the examples given here. So weekdays, it is a list having days from Monday to Sunday. In a pack of cards, we have values from 2 to 10, followed by Jack, Queen, King, and Ace. And when we take the example of the floors of a building, we find the basement, ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor, and so on. Similarly, in a student's attendance sheet, we find the list of students' name one after the other. So what is that we have understood from the examples means that a list is a finite ordered sequence of data items, which is known as elements. The list is said to be empty when we find no elements in the list. And the number of elements stored in the list will be called as the length of the list. The beginning of the list is called as head of the list and the end is called its tail. Now suppose if we consider an example having the list of n values like A0, A1, A2, A3, AN-1, here the subscripts like 0, 1, 2, 3, etc., they actually indicates the position of the elements in the list. Now, to create this kind of list, we can either use array-based sequential list or the linked list. Now, the array-based sequential list, it makes use of an array to store the elements of the list. And here, the size of the array must be known in the beginning itself, means before execution. Now, in computer's memory, the data will be stored in continuous memory locations, and always the first element's indexed value will start from zero. The different operations that can be performed on the list are that we find the length of the list, we can find the length of the given list, and we can read the list from either left to right or from right to left, and we can retrieve any element from the list, also insert an element into the list or delete an element from the list. Yes, now let us know what is an array. So array is an ordered collection of data elements of the same data type with same name, and it can also be defined as a structured data type consisting of a group of elements of the same type with same name. An array, it is a linear data structure where the elements are stored one after the other, that is in successive memory locations. So once the array size is declared, that is while creation, it cannot be changed during the execution. Types of arrays. In arrays, we have three types, one-dimensional, two-dimensional, and multi-dimensional. A one-dimensional array, it is a structured data type consisting of elements of the same data type with same name and has one subscript. For example, int num of 100. So which means num is an array which can store maximum of 100 elements of the type integer. Similarly, two-dimensional array, it is a structured data type consisting of elements of the same data type with same name but has two subscripts, one for row and the other for the column. So the first subscript value, it represents the number of rows, and the second subscript value, it represents the number of columns. So in this example, we see that there are four rows and four columns. Now, multidimensional array, it is a structured data type consisting of elements of the same data type and same name, but has more than two subscripts. So in the example, we see that student is an array of the type integer, and it can store 10 into 5 into 3, which is 150 elements of the type integer. Next, we shall understand more about one-dimensional array. So one-dimensional array is a finite set of homogeneous data elements of size n, such that each element in the list will be referenced by an index value and will be stored in successive memory locations. In C, to declare an array, we use the syntax as data type space array name followed by the size of the array within a square bracket. So in the example given here, int a of 10 means a is an array of size 10, and it means that it can store 10 elements, all of the type integer. So here you know that int means 2 bytes. So to store 10 elements, 10 into 2, which is 20, that is 20 successive memory locations are reserved for the array A. So moving on, let's see how to find the length of an array. The formula is length is equal to upper bound minus the lower bound plus 1. So in the example, the upper bound is equal to 9. And lower bound is equal to 0. So the length of the array is 10. So here we should note that array size has to be fixed in the beginning itself, that is at the time of creation, and the size cannot be altered during the execution. Next, we shall see the different operations possible on arrays. So first is the traversal, which means we can process each element in an array exactly once. So this is useful when we want to print the elements in the list, or when we want to search for an element in the list, we can traverse the list. Second is search. So here we can traverse through the list and search for the given element and return its position in the list. Now the third operation is insertion. So here we can insert an element into the list at the end of the list or at any given position. Similarly, deletion operation is to delete an element from the list, and sorting is to organize or arrange the elements in the list either in ascending or descending order. And merging is to combine two or more list to form a single list. Array as ADT. So far you have seen what is an array. So array is also an abstract data type that can hold collection of elements accessible by an index. So in order to access any element from an array, we can retrieve by specifying its index value. For example, in the diagram, you see that we have an array ARR with 6 elements, 25, 35, 45, 53, 25, and 7. And their index values are starting from the value 0 to 5. Also, we see each element's memory locations. Hence, using abstract data type, we could know the type of data stored and the different types of operations that can be performed on them. Now let us see some of the operations which I mentioned previously. So here, for example, the copy operation is to store a value from one variable into another variable. So here, the value is equal to A of I means the ith element value in the list is being assigned to the variable value. And traversal is to process all the elements of the list at least once. So here, to print the elements in the list, we must know the size of the array. And in the example, we have the statement for I is equal to 0 to I less than n I plus plus printf percentage d A of I, which means when I is 0, it outputs or prints the first element in the list. And when I changes to 2, it prints the second element in the list. Likewise, as and when I value changes, the values in the array list are printed. So once I value reaches the final value, it prints the last element in the list. Now similarly, searching is an operation to find for an element in the list. And if it is found, we can even specify its position in the list. So in the example given here, item is the element to be searched from the list. And we see that when we traverse through the list, we are checking if that element and the item are equal. So if they are found to be equal, then we output that element item is found at position I plus 1. And suppose if none of the elements matched with item, we can give a message that item is not found in the list. So what are the benefits of using ADT? Means code is easier to understand and implementation of ADTs can be changed without requiring any changes to the program that uses the ADT. Okay, so we have come to the end of this video session, and in my next video, you will be learning about representation of linear arrays in memory. Thank you for listening.